Oh, we all do. We all have contact with the white supremacists for benefits because we are prisoners of war. So if you're a victim of white supremacy, a non-white person anywhere on the planet, any time of day or night, you are a prisoner of war. You are born in prison. So therefore, you know, if you get some cornbread or if you have a weakness for a white person sexually and all like that, that goes with the territory because you're a prisoner. So what you say about it is just that. Prisoners of war act like prisoners of war. That's why we have to get rid of the system of racism, because it is what it is. We'll remain this way. Our existence doesn't really mean anything. We say Black Lives Matter and all like that. Matter in what context? See, when we, you know, this is an excellent statement to make, but then that calls for a lot of in-depth discussion. How do Black Lives Matter? And what do they matter for? In order to accomplish what? What makes a black life matter? See, it might be 1,000 questions right behind that one statement. I understand a couple of black ladies coined the phrase, but if you're going to discuss that, that calls for maybe, I don't know, maybe 20 questions, maybe 30 questions, maybe 3,000 questions, you know? Matter how, when, where, in what context, as compared to what, as compared to whom, in what area of activity. So in answer to the question, oh yes, what's your response to it? That's to be expected. That's the response. Anytime a black person does anything in the system of white supremacy, whether it's correct or incorrect, It just is what it is. You're still a prisoner of war. See, this is why it's so imperative to just concentrate on one thing, not pecking around the edges of the system of racism like it's supposed to exist forever. That's what we have been doing as victims of racism. No, it is a system of government that should never have existed in the first place. So you always look at it like that. You don't look at it any other way. Something that never should have existed at all. Not for one fraction of a second. No one is supposed to be mistreated because of the color of the skin. That is insane.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That is super insanity. People shouldn't be mistreated for any reason. But, I mean, that is one of the most shallow reasons you can, you know, that's like saying, a person that has one fingernail longer than the other is eligible to be mistreated. It's in the same context. The color of the skin makes you eligible to be mistreated. The fact that this has lasted so long, this an idea like that shouldn't have taken off for even a fraction of a second. That should have been laughable. For the first person to even mention that. But it's no joke.
No joke.
And it has become the most powerful government that the world has ever seen, called the system of white supremacy, where every non-white person is made, by even before birth, to be eligible for mistreatment by anybody who is white, in particular, and if it's the occasion to satisfy a person who's classified as white, anybody who's non-white can mistreat another non-white person. That's the whole racist doctrine. So therefore, in a capsule, you should expect anything to happen that shouldn't happen in the system of white supremacy to a non-white person.